I was very interested in your topic, and I was just like, oh, where does this come from? And because if you do a search on the open web, or if you look in the catalog or on Amazon, it kind of trends towards the popular press and less scholarly. And I'm like, that doesn't make sense. And so I looked in, oh, I don't have it up on my tabs. I prepared a menu of things to look at. I looked in Scopus for the title of one of the author's books, and it was just like, there wasn't very little cited. I'm like, what's going on? What am I doing wrong? So let me walk you through what I did, but I think there's gaps. So first thing, I hit the Wikipedia after I got frustrated with a couple searches, and I found out that this person comes out of the psychology profession or discipline. I think that would inform a lot of where we might search. So there is the database called PsycINFO. That might be a lot more productive. And it also, if it's evolved from person-centered therapy, and it's also like not a de-escalation, but like a conflict resolution sort of a thing, there's different angles we can approach it from that. So like, why does it exist? And maybe to solve conflict. I don't know. But having it come out of psychology is really helpful. The next thing that I did, oh, they even have like the highlights. Isn't the web a modern miracle these days? When I went to Google Ngrams, which I also love to do, I wanted to see precedents for it. Because, you know, the Gandhi's been around, and also the civil rights protesters in the 60s used nonviolence as a practice. And so I looked up nonviolent communication with hyphen and without the hyphen. And Google Ngrams looks at like full text of books. They typically show up in academic libraries, but there's a heavy trend for this starting around the time that it makes sense, the Wikipedia entry, but it doesn't take off in academic libraries until like after the turn of the century, which is really cool, and it really takes off. But if you go up and put, I guess it doesn't matter. If you go up, put up nine violence, these two get squashed flat. So nonviolence is, but again, nonviolence doesn't come out of a therapy or a psychology. It comes more out of like political change and protest and movements and things like that. So I think there's a lot of merit in psychology and in therapy or an intervention for something going on. But be that as it may, Google Ngrams is fun. Next one I went to is I was like, oh, what's the title of a book that this person has written? And you can go and look at the metadata and see how it was described. Interpersonal communication. Well, that narrows it down. Kind of ambiguous and general. So I copied the title of the book, and then I went, oh, there's Scopus. We'll go back to Scopus. Then I went to Google Scholar. Oh, no, I remember what happened. In Scopus, I'll show you this. I did a search for the book, and there was like one thing that cited it. And I'm like, that doesn't make sense. And here you can see I've already put it in. Because you can put in the name of an author, and Scopus is problematic because it wants to truncate the first names. And so I don't know if he's ML or MS or MC, but we'll find out. But if you type in the name of the title and put it in quotes, in Scopus, Web of Science also, it has like a different author. I'm like, no, I can't click on that author. And there was only one citation. And so I was like, that's not helpful. But since I thought that this might dip over into the popular press, let's look in Google Scholar, because it dips heavily into that well instead of being so stodgy like us academic librarians. And I will show you what I found instead. So here's the book, and here's our author, M.B. Rosenberg. So I think in Google Scholar you can click on the author, but check this out. It's been cited since it was published in 2015, which seems kind of late for all of this. Is that like a later book? Be that as it may, it's been cited thousands of times. And if you click on those citations, this might be where you find what you're looking for. So you can see there's like methods that's tied to mindfulness. I'm like, what isn't tied to mindfulness? And some random stuff like biological soil crusts. What does that have to do with anything? But here's queer methods, peace journalism. A title of peace journalism might not show up in academia, might, But you can see where I was going. Some of these things might not be what we were looking for. And it looks like they're, it might be like a, justifiably so, an activist intervention where you're like, hey, there's a lot of problems in society. Evoking excellence in others and the controversial life coaches and things like that. So I think psychology might be the best way to go. But the participatory action research. So you know how to find the psychology stuff. It's under databases, and then there's a pull-down menu. Go to psychology, and psych info is at the top. I would start there with related keywords and things like that. But let me know how it goes. This sounds really cool. I did a presentation. I will show you. I'd be proud to show this to you. campusguides.lib.utah.edu/disinformation. And I worked with a couple of your colleagues in COM, a couple of new faculty. And it was like, can we use, and introduced by you, by the way, from some of these concepts, is can we use cognitive behavioral therapy as an intervention for people who are suffering at the hands of disinformation and propaganda? And so there's a poster I presented at the American Library Association. But you can see the sections of the poster in tab where you can grab the whole thing. Take a look, or if you want to see the poster. I'm trying to develop a research plan so I can work with grad students who are kind of bridging the gap between faculty and students in developing curriculum and see if this works with them. Prepare to get depressed for some of my samples. The rest of this is in an email. So pleased to talk with you again.